gentlemen, this is the Mega Cebu 2019 Candidates Forum. Now your host, the chairman of the University of San Carlos Political Science Department School of Law and Governance, Miss Brinette Avrenica.
May hapon sa tanan. Solo ko karon. Okay. So we are actually live streamed today, as usual, in all of our sessions. And we'd like to thank, of course, the candidates who said yes to our invitation for this afternoon's candidates forum. And please do take note that this is the fifth of the local series. We have had our national series for the entire month of March. And we started our local series last 5th of April. We had the 5th a.m. and afternoon, and April 8, April 10, and then we rested for the Holy Week, and after Easter, we're back on track. And we still have actually 4 sessions after this afternoon. We will have on Wednesday, on Friday, and 2 sessions on Monday, a.m. and p.m. This is how we prepare for the elections, right? And we also would like to thank our volunteers from Ramon Aboitiz Foundation Incorporated, our partners from the different institutions, Klarohay Ta, or ato yung klaruho, no? From our candidates via our platform that we provide for each of them. The local government units that we cluster this afternoon are neighbors in the north, okay? And they cover Liloan. We have our candidates from the municipality of Liloan, the first-class municipality up north. We also have a third-class municipality up north, come close to or next to Liloan, Compostela. And after that, the city of Danao, a third-class city in North Cebu. Before we proceed with everything that the program this afternoon actually provides, you may be wondering why of all Mega Cebu is doing or organizing a candidates forum. This is not the first. This is actually the third in a row. They started in 2013. It was quite exclusive to Mega Cebu audience. You have the technocrats, you have businessmen. In 2016, they opened it up to the public, but they realized the Cebuano community needs to be engaged far more than they have engaged in 2013 and 2016 respectively. So they partnered with the academe, and in particular the University of San Carlos. Why? Because we are part of this Cebuano vote. Whatever the vote may be, whether it's an intellectual vote or a challenging vote or a swing vote, we are yet to define that in the coming election. But what is so important about getting engaged, and what is so important about Cebuano voters being engaged? And I think this particular notion of Bugsay principle that has been championed by the late Bobby Aboitiz speaks so much of what is meant by this candidates forum. Mega Cebu making waves. The meaning of making waves is wholesome. Come help me here. Wholesome. What's A again? Advanced. Very good. Vibrant. Very good. I'm getting audience participation. This is interesting. E is equitable and sustainable. Do we want Cebu to be wholesome, advanced, vibrant, equitable, and sustainable? Yes. Yes, of course. No. So we will be using the principle, we will be following the principle of Bugsay from the late Sir Bobby for us to actually realize that voters and candidates alike, we each have our own paddle. And if only candidates and voters paddle together to a single direction, it is not impossible for Cebu to reach its heights. And why is it so important? Importante kay siya, it's because Cebu gives an epitome of urbanization in the country. Metro Manila has had its chance, but it seemed like Metro Manila is not a good example of an urbanized locale. Cebu is given that chance now. And candidates and voters alike, we are given this chance to actually make the appropriate and the right decision. And I think with everything that has been laid out for us, with the excitement of the campaign that has been going on for days and weeks already, the decision of the voters is still hanging in there. No? Mura grab, hang tight. There still are, you know, weighing who among the candidates will they give their votes? Who among the candidates can actually speak and respond to their needs as Cebuanos and the communities they represent? So that will be the tone of our discussion later on. We will be tackling the different themes of Mega Cebu, 7 of them, and we hope that our candidates can also engage our voters in how they weigh their choices for the upcoming May 13, 2019 elections. Before I proceed to calling for our COMELEC representative, please do note that our session today will be aired via MyTV, Sky Cable Channel 30, every MWF, 12 to 1:45 p.m. And as I said, we're live streamed. That's livestream.com/MyTV30/onair. And we also are active on Facebook. We're actually airing live this via Facebook. We have facebook.com/mytvchannel.com. For those who are active in social media, please do check facebook.com/megacebu2050 and facebook.com/megacebucandidatesforum. For those who will be posting pictures or comments, please do use the hashtags. One, hashtag Mega Cebu Klarohay Ta with an exclamation point at the end, and hashtag Mega Cebu Candidates Forum 2019. And I think we're ready. Yeah? At this particular point, I'd like to call in our COMELEC representative to give us our welcome remarks, Election Officer 4 and assigned for Provincial Election Supervisor Office, Attorney Ferdinand Guhilde. A round of applause.
Thank you, Ma'am Bren. Thank you, Ma'am Bren. Okay. Salamat, no? And I'm so glad that today there is going to be candidates from the Danao City. Yes? Okay. Maybe you might find this unfortunate, but I'm going to be the one assigned in the Danao City for the forthcoming elections. So I assumed office actually last April 10. Okay, April 10. Sige, so welcome sa inyong tanano and daghang salamat ngayong gitagano gigayon ang atong candidates forum. And like what Ma'am Bren said, this is the only forum probably in Region 7 that is sanctioned by the COMELEC. And the only reason is because we sanction it because it is nonpartisan. As a matter of fact, when we gave out invitations to all candidates, we did not choose one over the other. Each candidate was given an invitation. But maybe some had a prior commitment, so we have to respect that. So today, we're going to be given a platform to raise the level of public discourse in so far as the election is concerned. And I'm so glad that we are here at the University of San Carlos, where the students, as I always say, you know, the students are best known for being critical, independent. So, for us who want to raise the level of public discourse, debate for elections, I think this is the best venue for candidates to ventilate and probably convince the others in their platform of government. Beyond name recall, beyond mudslinging, this is the best place to be in so far as public debate and discourse is concerned for the forthcoming elections. Thank you and good afternoon.
Thank you very much. And for our ground rules, I would like to invite our candidates to please keenly listen to our ground rules and mechanics.
Here are the ground rules and mechanics for candidates. This forum shall provide a platform for both candidates and voters to engage each other to guide the discernment of voters in their choice of candidates in the May 13, 2019 midterm elections. This is not a debate. The format will not tolerate grandstanding and overexposure of selected candidates. Candidates must address the question, what can you offer Cebu Province in general and Metro Cebu in particular as it experiences urbanization? Campaign videos and banners will not be allowed in the forum. Only a 5-slide PowerPoint presentation is allowed, and only if it is aligned with the candidate's message or answer during the opening remarks and the facilitated discussion. Be mindful of your time allocation. All candidates must strictly follow the allotted time per segment. Opening and closing messages are limited to a maximum of 3 minutes per candidate. The hosts will provide a cue for your time allocation during the facilitated discussions and the interaction time with the audience. An electronic timer will guide each speaker for this purpose. No candidate is allowed to use foul language in both in the main speech and responses. A candidate who violates this rule will be reprimanded. If the offense is repeated after the reprimand, the candidate will be politely asked to leave the forum. Candidates are instructed to engage each other with respect and dignity. Speakers are not allowed to use insults and damaging insinuations against each other, especially if these can trigger heated discussions. A limited number of campaign supporters may join the delegation of the candidate, but they are not allowed to openly campaign or loiter in any part of the campus. Rules for audience and participants. We have a multi-stakeholder audience, from the academe, educators, students and staff, labor, transport groups, urban poor, women, agriculture, among other sectors. As stakeholders, our primary question to each candidate is, what can you do for the Cebu province in general and Metro Cebu in particular? To ensure that issues from all sectors are tackled, questions from the audience may be written in sheets of paper handed out by ushers and usherettes at the forum. Questions will be checked and finalized with the screening committee. No foul language will be tolerated from the participants or audience in their questions or random comments. Ushers will approach violators in their seats to reprimand them. Noise will not be allowed for the entire duration of the forum. Those who disturb the session will be reprimanded and may be asked to leave the hall as needed. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So at this particular point, I'd like to remind our candidates that while we are discussing here, a team of one is actually at the back who will be documenting all the commitments that will be articulated by the candidates. And before we close the forum this afternoon, we will flash your commitments and for you to check whether they are correctly documented. So at this particular point, I'd like to enumerate the different Mega Cebu themes that we will cover. First, we will have transport and traffic management, road improvement and infrastructure development, health, sanitation and waste management, environmental management, public safety, metropolitan management and culture, heritage, preservation and tourism. So let us not make further ado. I'd like to call in our candidates. From Liloan, for the mayoral candidate from PDP Laban, Attorney Christina Frasco. Following her, the vice mayoral candidate, also from PDP Laban, Ms. Thelma Jordan. From Compostela, mayoral candidate from PDP Laban, Mr. Richie Wagas. Finally, but not the least, Vice Mayoral Candidate from Danao City, also from PDP Laban, Mr. Michael Enriquez. You may choose your chair. Actually, we sent invitation to 7 people for this particular cluster. However, 3 of them had to decline just minutes before the forum started because of prior commitments. All right, so candidates, you have your electronic timer. Each of you will be given 3 minutes to give your opening message. And after that, we will have some facilitated discussion. All right, Attorney Christina.
Mayong hapon kaninyong tanan. I'm Christina Garcia Frasco, the mayor of the municipality of Liloan, a first-class municipality with one of the highest population growth rates in the province of Cebu. As of local estimates, our population stands at over 140,000. When I began my term in 2016, Liloan had already obtained historic growth and progress. And so the challenge for me and my team was to ensure continuity and to instill innovations in governance. I'm happy to say that we have been able to make gains in that regard. The 8-point agenda of the previous administration of Mayor Duke Frasco, we extended to a 10-point agenda. We maintained as our number one priority the aspect of education. And from over 2,000 scholars in 2016, we now have 3,549 scholars of Liloan. Health and social services has also been a priority of our administration. In Liloan, if you are a resident, you are able to avail of medical, financial, and burial assistance of up to 50,000 pesos. And we have financial subsidies that we maintain in two public hospitals in case of confinement. We've also tried to improve on the aspect of public infrastructure, knowing how vital it is to improve on this aspect, Liloan being part of Metro Cebu. And that is why in these past 3 years, we've been able to concrete and asphalt no less than 12,000 meters of roads. We've been able to build 5 concrete bridges, 3 water systems, 9 covered courts, 11 drainage and flood control projects, and additional classroom buildings for our young students. We've also tried to implement a type of governance that is focused on community participation, which is why we have been able to improve on our local Purok system, which encourages stakeholders in the grassroots to engage in our government programs. And this has really allowed us to change the face of Liloan for the better. As part of Metro Cebu, we are fully committed to the goals of Mega Cebu, and we are happy to have been able to participate in many of Mega Cebu's activities in the past 3 years. And we are very proud to say that these gains have allowed for Liloan to be chosen as the number one municipality in the province of Cebu under the Our Cebu program. We hope to be able to continue to charge forward towards our goals for sustainable and inclusive development for all Iloanans, with the goal of uplifting the quality of life for all and to further address the challenges that we face as a growing municipality that is on the cusp of cityhood. Ultimately, our vision for Liloan is to become the premier city in the province of Cebu that is an ideal place to live, study, work, and invest. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mayor Christina. Vice Mayor Thelma.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Thelma Limpag Jordan, running for the position of Vice Mayor of the Municipality of Liloan. As earlier indicated by Mayor Frasco, Liloan is a first-class municipality up north. It is approximately 18 kilometers from Cebu City. Actually, I was elected as councilor in the 2016 election and moved up as Vice Mayor when Vice Mayor-elect Duke Frasco accepted the appointment of President Duterte as Commissioner of the Cebu Ports Authority. But I have also served as legislator for more than 20 years in Liloan. And in fact, I have witnessed and we have passed in the Sanggunian several ordinances. And the most notable, the recent ones, is the local code for children. We also created the traffic code and created the Liloan Traffic Commission. We also created the Municipal Commission for the Welfare of Women, Children, and Family. We also had the Market Code, the Environment and Sanitation Code, and many others. Last year, 2018, Liloan received a plaque. I mean, Liloan Sanggunian Bayan received a plaque of recognition for being a finalist in the search for best local legislative body conducted by the Department of Interior and Local Government and the province of Cebu. And these achievements that we have, and as outlined by our mayor, were achieved because we are one, the Sanggunian Bayan support the plans and programs of our mayor. And as legislator, it is also our goal to pass appropriate legislations that may be necessary in the to make these plans achievable and to achieve these plans for the benefit not only of Liloan but for the province of Cebu and particularly the dreams of Mega Cebu. So it's our dream, it's our call that we live and love Liloan.
Thank you very much. All right. Following next, Mr. Richie Wagas for Compostela.
Daghang salamat. Mayong hapon sa tanan nga nagsunod nining maong programa sa Mega Cebu. By the way, sugo sa may pamatasan, magpaila ko, ako si Richie Reyes Wagas, kanhi mayor sa lungsod sa Compostela ni atong tuig 2007 o hantong sa 2010. Hapit sad mo balik pagka mayor pagka 2010, nagka-problema lang tungod sa resulta sa picos machine. And I have to emphasize that I was the first mayor siguro nga ni question sa resulta sa picos machine unya gibawi sa Commission on Elections ang proclamation on the basis of evidence presented sa among witness nga taga Smartmatic gyud nga representative. I think the famous columnista Bobit Avila is following on my case. Unya sa pagkatinuod, we went to the court for manual recounting. For the first time in the computerized elections in the country, we have proven nga ang resulta sa picos machine wa magtakdo sa resulta sa manual recount dito sa Regional Trial Court in Mandawi City. Due to time constraints, namutid ang kaso, but there was an order from the court detailing all the results of the elections that katong giingon nga presidente nga pildi mi, daog mi, by overall count, we won in that elections. But to me, assuming the post was no longer that important, what is important that the people knew the truth and nothing but the truth, because for us, the truth will set us free. Moving forward, 2013, 2016, 2019 is a very important elections to us. We had known to be a family like me fighting against tyrants. We were in the front lines during the 1986 People Power Revolution. Until now, we are fighting our own tyrants in our district. And we have been fighting until now, and this 2019 elections under President Digong Duterte, we hope and pray that this is the time, a divine justice, that indeed change will come in the 5th district of Cebu. Kami na amis sa tunga-tunga sa Danao o sa Liloan. On our southern side, we have Liloan. Very inspiring nga lungsod. And I hope that leadership in Liloan will transcend all over the 5th district of Cebu and replace that recycled leadership in Danao City. I'm sorry, Attorney Mike, but with your resurgence now and becoming the new leader of Danao, I can have two inspirations. On the southern side, we have Liloan. On the northern side, under the leadership of our party mates in Danao, we'll have a vibrant and a fully developed district under the inspirations of these two great municipalities like Liloan and Danao City. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wagas. Now we'll have the vice mayoral candidate for Danao City, Mr. Michael Enriquez.
Mayong hapon natong tanan. First of all, I would be speaking also for and in behalf of our mayoral candidate, Eleonor Eli Duterte. She's not able to come here because she's still recuperating because she got a withdrawal syndrome from smoking. So her doctor advised her to rest. But it doesn't mean nga nipahulay siya sa iyaha nga kausa. Labi na niining ato ang panglimbasugan batok sa dugay-dugay na nga higayon nga namunuan sa siyudad sa Danao umbisan pa man sa Quinto Distrito. First of all, I'm very thankful that the persons here speaking are all my party mates. And despite the invitation, the other party was not able to come here. We give importance to gatherings and forum like this because it is also our means na mapaabot ngadto sa katawhan unsa pod ang mga panghitabo. This is not an isolated world. The fight in Danao will not only be a fight for Danao, but it will be a fight for the whole district as well as a fight for the whole province of Cebu. Una, taas-taas na higayon nga usa lamang ka pamilya ang namunuan dito sa Dakbayan sa Danao. Our president came from Danao. And they were forced to leave Danao because of the politics, kind of politics in Danao. So mauna nga hataga na tog bag-o nga hulagway ang Danao. Danao will not only be associated with that one family name. Danao is for all Danawanons. And everybody is welcome to invest in Danao. So that's why usaka ibalik nato ang pagsalig sa mga katawhan nga kaning ang ato ang syudad sa Danao dili lamang sa usa lamang kapamilya kundi abli. And I know that with the Duterte administration, the dominant family name in Danao will be a thing of the past. Change will come in Danao. Manghitabo lamang na kung ang mga katawhan ang kasing-kasing na sa ilang dughan, dili kay ang kasing-kasing na himutang diha sa bulsa. And I know it will come by God's time and by God's grace. Salamat na itong tanan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Enriquez. Okay, let's start our discussion. How are you coping with the campaign nowadays? Can you share your experiences? Maybe the highlights of the campaign for the past few days?
Well, we've been fortunate enough to have some rest during the Holy Week. And happy Easter day sa tanan, no? We've been very happy to continue our cause for continuity din hi sa Liloan. And in these many nights and days that we have campaigned, malipayon kayo ta na daghan gyud kayo ang ni padayag sa ilang hugot kaayo na suporta. Nagpahibaw na niuban sila kanato nining atong kausa sa gugma o kalambuan sa Liloan. So it's been a very positive campaign from our end. I don't know if I can say that from the other camp. But we've tried to maintain a very forward-looking campaign that's placed on platforms, projects, and accomplishments.
Thank you. What about Ma'am Tama?
Actually, it's very challenging for me, ma'am. I just met an accident about 7 months ago, and I started walking without any assistive device in March. So I still have my titanium implant here in both my legs, and it is really very sore at the end of the night. I mean, after the campaign rally, but the fight goes on. I still want to serve Liloan.
Okay, thank you very much. It's the spirit. Yes, Mr. Wagas.
Nindot ka ining kampanya. Kay mao ni saka platform that somehow you can share your advocacies. Unya, maka-edukar saka sa mga butante. Labi na kami, ang among battle cry is to liberate our district from an abusive dynasty now for 70 long years. That we have to change. So, muna yan. Amo ronggi kampanya dito, more in education, more than the winning. No? I want the people to win because there will be elections every three years. And I think this is the right time for the people to rise up and make that change happen in that abusive dynasty in Danao City. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Campaign education. Yes, sir.
Sa Danao, unlike in 2016, I was also a candidate in 2016. I ran for mayor that time. But this time, I slide down to vice mayor. Makita nimo ang kalainan. In 2016, the people in Danao medyo magpanghadlok. In fact, even during the campaign of President Duterte, campaign sorties niya, managu ang mga tao, imahadlok, kuyawan sa mga namunuan. But this time, I would say that the tungod kay midaog si President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, ang katawhan sa Danao naa na po'y courage. They come out to the open to voice out the real sentiments. But still, medyo pang paghadlok yapon na mga kampanya namo nga dili mi pasod loans covered court kay ma kay giingnan ang mga barangay captains nga di mi pasod loan, but still it's a challenge. Kung sama sa giingon during the time of the Lenten season, kung imong pahunungon, imong pahilumon ang mga tao, ang bato mo ay maninggit, the same thing goes with Danao. Karon that the people have the courage to voice out the real sentiments and they want change to happen in Danao.
Thank you very much. Now let's go to the different Mega Cebu themes. Let's talk about them one by one. And particularly, you can share about the platform, if they're included in your platform, or what have been the strides that you've had if you have been incumbent. For example, in the area of transport and traffic management, I think Liloan, Park Consolacion, Liloan, Compostela to Danao, these are very critical areas going up north. And access to the north will have to pass through your municipalities and city. So you have mentioned about, for Liloan, the making of a traffic code and the institutionalization of the traffic commission. What have we been doing in order to limit congestion in the area of Liloan? And later on, what are the plans of Compostela as well as of Danao? Turn Christina.
The first thing that we did during the start of our administration, having already had an institutionalized traffic commission and code, was really to study the choke points of Liloan, particularly ang among nakita kining sa Yate San Vicente na junction. And so, after some studies that we did there, atong gibuhat, nagputang taog mga plastic barriers sa tunga-tunga sa National Highway, and we implemented a strict no right turn, no left turn during certain times of the day. And that has really eased up the traffic along the National Highway. Second, with regard to the portion of the National Highway nearing our church, kaniadto na ay mga illegal vendors dihang dapita. And so in order for us to be able to manage traffic at itong mga sakyanan na muhunong sa National Highway para mupalit, we organized the illegal vendors and made them legal and constituted our Liloan food street. And by way of ordinance at ang creation ananiya, and that we manage traffic by implementing strict no-stopping zones and providing an area for cars to park should they wish to avail of the food street. Thirdly, one of the biggest developments during this administration has been the groundbreaking and soon to be the operations of our port of Liloan. This is a public-private partnership between Pier 88, the Archdiocese of Cebu, and the Municipality of Liloan. It is a 1 billion peso port facility at zero cost to the government. We anticipate that this will provide the solution to traffic in the north. Because 6 months from now, a ferry system will be operational that will be able to ferry passengers directly from Liloan to Mactan and subsequently Liloan to Cebu City. It is estimated that there are around 10,000 people who work in MEPS who are from the north. And so if we are able to take away a portion of that 10,000 population from the roads and put them in our ferry system, then that will ease up traffic greatly.
Thank you very much. Do you have anything to add, Ma'am Delma?
It's just the trip cutting before, practiced by some jeepney operators and drivers, were cut already because with the cooperation of a transport cooperative, they insist on from Liloan the driving the passengers to the end of Liloan, which is Kutkut. So it helped a lot with people already out of the street because they have already reached their destinations.
Okay, so you extended the destination to Kutkut rather than just the municipal poblacion area.
Actually, ma'am, it is from Cebu City to Kutkut, because the franchise is up to Liloan, and okay. Kutkut is the farthest barangay of Liloan.
Let me go back a little bit to Attorney Christina about the opening of the port in the next few months. Although we're looking at the possibility of decongesting our roads because we will be transferring our passengers from the road to the ferry system. Will this not also congest some cargoes coming through or via the port that you'll be opening? Or this is exclusive only for ferry system?
For now, the plan is for it to be a ferry system. There is an anticipated international port that will handle cargo, and that is on the Consolacion side, border Liloan. So purely, this will begin as a passenger terminal and a passenger port.
Okay. Moving forward to the Consolacion international port, how do you think Liloan should be prepared for possible congestion of cargoes accessing via the Consolacion port? Do you have any plans in mind already?
Well, before I answer your question, I'd just like to point out that the putting up of a port in Liloan is a very great development for us because it will provide an additional gateway to and from Liloan, considering that there are only two main access roads to our town, which is the National Highway and the North Coastal Road. And this was made possible during the incumbency of former Mayor Duke Frasco as Commissioner of the Cebu Port Authority. And we're very grateful that he was able to accomplish this project. For the international port in Consolacion, as I understand, the project is now with the DOTR. And we've had several meetings already with the DPWH to discuss the improvement of the road network to and from the port. And I am in current discussions with the DPWH as well for them to finally finish the long-awaited North Coastal Road that has been in a state of disrepair for many years. So we're very hopeful that with the participation of the DPWH, this road will finally be finished.
And this is in workings with other LGUs in the area, or only for those who are aggressive to work with the OTR?
Well, the main local government units that will really benefit and be affected by the development of the port and the roads will be Consolacion and Liloan.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's go to Compostela. About traffic.
About the traffic problem. It cannot be denied nga problema na gyud nga dako. Pero common sense will dictate us nga kung doon na pala integrated plan for the entire Mega Cebu, mas maayo unta ang solusyon. Kaya because mag-individual ang kada LGU og himo og formula, kuna na siya temporary nga remedial measures, but the long term nga solution is to have an integrated like the Metro Manila Development Authority. As early as now, mayon ta na matukod na siya para magka-synchronize. No, kay for example, simple kay nga problema sa helmet ordinance sa Mandawi, kinahanglan full gig ka. Ang akong motorista kas Compostela half pra. Inig-abot sa Mandawi dakpon. So, kinahanglan gyud do na gyud integrated from Danao to the last part sa Mega Cebu. So tukuro na gina, that is the most important nga solution for the moment. Samtang nagtunaw na pata og expansion ng alternative roads para to add at solve the problem sa traffic. Karon ang management gyud mismo at least makatabang sa flow sa traffic, masulbad ang mga problema.
Okay, so you'd like to harp on the need for an integrated solution rather than an individualistic per LGU approach.
Yeah, for example, Liloan, they have a good solution for their own. But how about the traffic from Compostela, Liloan going to the city? So that is a bottleneck problema. So kinahanglan maghimog og integrated manage because the national road is owned by the national government.
Yes.
We can only do so much within our respective territories. Mas maayod na agi Osaka governing body to manage the traffic problem here in the Mega Cebu in particular.
Yeah, but
I think what that requires is good leadership from the province of Cebu to be able to rally all the mayors together, to work together, to have an integrated plan. As I understand, in the past 3 years, we've had several discussions with Mega Cebu in coming up with a coordinated body for all traffic commissions of all LGUs to work together. So, nang hinaot sad ta, og mayo pod na leadership sa probinsya sa Cebu to be able to get all the mayors to work together.
Okay.
Mo na nga among kampanya ron, vote straight. Okay. Among ang presidente, among gobernador, among BC, niya amo tanang mayor.
Okay.
Masulta ng problema. That's the solution.
Vote straight, all right. Let's go to Danao City.
Although the Danao City is the only city in the 5th district, and it is the northernmost tip of Mega Cebu. As of now, dili ingon ana pa kay kagrabe ang traffic as a problem. Unlike sa transition nimo from Mandawi to Consolacion, then Consolacion transition to Liloan. But ultimately, mahimo gyud ang problema with the continuing urbanization ang mga tao mag-anam kadaghan. Kung atong i-rely with the main road, it's owned by the national government. So, it needs an integrated plan, a system, integrated system. Ongoing ang widening program, no? Pag-widening sa roads, although it's long been delayed. Supposed to be, it should have been done already, finished by the time of GMA. But until now, wala pa gyud gapon ma-fully implemented ang widening of roads. Then kung sa city lang, I think we're trying to link, to create a link, no, sa, like sa amo, sa Danao. Doon na i-open up na link to the western part of Cebu through Asturias to Buran area. So mga alternate routes, no, alternate nga mga roads na to. Connecting also to Compostela, makalabas, makagawas na po may padong sa Cebu City. So, ginagmay, no, at least ang the road would not only be arterial, nga kanarang main arteries lang, but it should be more of circumferential sa nga, even connecting the northern part to the western part of Cebu. Hinay-hinay na nato sa Danao. Hopefully, like ang Danao, kuad man mi, naaman mi Mitsumi, daghan ang mga workers. So, pasalamat mi with the, kuano, gisulti po ni Mayor Cristina, they're opening up a ferry system. So, at least kung ang land transportation, dili na kaayo tungod sa heavy traffic sa ilang area, mo make use mi sa ilahang kining ferry system. Also in Danao, doon na naigatong water bus nga project. Hopefully it's a private company. Hopefully it will be operational nga gamito na po nato ang ato ang mga waterways nga mahimo nato nga alternative nga kining ato ang transport system. Also, we're looking at the kining pagtabang pod. Although this is a reality, no? Kining kumusulod ka sa mga hilit-hilit, remote areas, kining habal-habal. Although there's a national law na nag-regulate, na doon naman ito yung mga amendments, still, dili pag yun na mawala. Sa akong nakita lang, ha, for the next 2 years, 2 to 3 years, di pag itaw na mawala ang kaning sahabal-habal. So siguro mo focus po me to assist as well as to ensure the safety of the commuting public regarding the kuno to pagpatronize nila sa kaning habal-habal mode of transportation.
Thank you very much. I understand that as far as traffic is concerned, there are actually many approaches. One is opening the sea area to actually transport passengers. And you're also looking at providing alternative routes within your locality that is beyond the national highway, just to provide access to our commuting public. Now, in the area of sanitation and health, and perhaps also a little bit of environment, we have a very realistic problem on water supply. What have been the priorities of the local government units, and what are the plans for those who are running to office about ensuring that your own communities do have sustainable water supply? Shall we start with Mr. Enriquez?
ang water project in Danao is I may say pagkakaroon wala ma-meet ang expectations. There's a dam project, 429 million loan supposed to be to be completed 2013, but until now wala gyud, wala pagyoy agas. So Danao has water source. In fact, doon na may mga bodies of kuno kani mga groundwater na interconnected po even to the tributaries in Carmen. So doon na po may untapped nga sources dito sa bukid. It is ambitious katong ang present administration, a very ambitious project nila nga magdam nga project. Although that could provide a long-term solution kay dako man nga body sa tubig ang mapundok. But sayop lang ang ilang area nga gibutangan. Siguro usa sa abo nga nakita would be to tap the katong mga naay mga water sources nga wala pa gyud ma-develop. Probably reservoir dito sa mga mountainous areas. Then ang kining pag-check po to coordinate with MCWD because they have data and research regarding sa kaning potential nga mga makuhaan na itong tubig. Then usa sa siguro would be kining responsible use and conservation. Wala may unlike Compostela, there are watershed areas. But in Danao, walay watershed areas. So, usa siguro na sa nato nga tanawon nga for water to be sustainable, there must be areas nga mo collect sa kuno like watershed areas. Danao has none. So, usa siguro na nato nga makita pud nga pamaagi. Then kining dunay project that needs to be reviewed. Naami bulk water project nga ibaligya to Ayala as well as MCWD. Pero for me, dapat dili unahon ang imong contractual obligations. In your contractual obligations nga dili kay unahon nimo ang pagbaligya. You should cater to the needs of the constituency. Then if you have excess, then you could sell it out. But ang hitabo karon presently, giuna ang supply for Ayala as well as to MCWD. Then ang sobra, mauna no i-supply to the constituency. I think that is a wrong priority. So, siguro kung matutukan lang, matarong lang na siya, problem agad. Kaya hangtod karon maglinya man may sa kanang buntag sa iyo, maglinya may, kaya wala may agas tubig.
So you're experiencing now insufficient water supply.
Yes.
Is this all over Danao?
It is.
Okay.
Oh. So morning, dili man na band-aid solution ra man na ang pag-rationing, water rationing. That's only a band-aid solution. The long term would be there must be some areas that will be declared watershed areas. Then dili na may labtan, makakoleka sufficient groundwater. Then dam is dako, but it might, relating to environment, it might have some environmental impacts. So it would be weighing in, timbang-timbangon yun kung unsa ang mahimo nga benepisyo, if it could outweigh the damage that it could cause to the environment.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Wagas, for Compostela.
With God's blessings, daghan mig tubig dito. Pero ang nakaproblema lang, mag-usap-usap ang political leadership. So, sad to note, ang mga programa sa patubig, under mami sa MCWD, ang ilang programa, unsa ang pagdaas among tubig padung sa syudad.
So it's Compostela's water, providing water to the rest of the city.
Oh, yeah, para na ako, sayop man na, because mm-hmm. The core of development, ang mga tao mismo. Mm-hmm. Unahon sa namo ang among kagalingong constituents. So doon ay mga restrictions sa watershed law o kining requirements sa Cebu City because we are under Metro Cebu Water District. Isa may matawagon nga mga dao mi. But first comes first. Charity begins at home. So unahon ang mga tao. So and yet, ang sa among lungsod nga sakop sa MCWD, mga 20% ra lang na servant dito. Dapay mga barangay, farthest barangay nga naglisod pa o water system. So karon with the project sa Mega Cebu, ang pagprepara sa among lungsod for urbanization, para nako ang unahon gigandam ang among mga tao unsa ilang mga basic needs before this migration will come in as a result of urbanization. So historically doon na may 14 deep wells. In fact part ang University of San Carlos sa study ana daghan kami tubig unya because of political leadership wa ka pa andar dako kay gasto makatabang unta to sa kaugalingon among needs. Unya, it was an issue taken against us. Kay mahubsan ko no ang tubig o pandaron ang 14 deep wells. Unya, nga akong rason na to, ang unang mag-uol kung mahubsan o tubig, ang nagnegosyo. Unsa pa may baligyan ng tubig, mahubsan na. Di ba? And yet, that is still a political issue until this time. And yet, we are facing the problem of a good water system for our constituents.
But is Compostela, as of now, experiencing rationing of water or not at all?
Naatay mga barangay sa Lagyo Taong Gayong Bukid. Mm-hmm. During my time, I used the facilities sa local government nga mag-transport og tubig padung sa bukid in town. Kaya labi na karon experiencing sa El Nino,
yes.
Naagyo yung mga tubod nga nahubsan in town. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine, usa ka lungsod 25 kilometers from Cebu City going to the north, maproblema pag tubig? And yet we are declared kasagaran sa among area as a watershed area. Nakuhang ka na kanang dako kay na nga question mark nga abundant ta sa tubig nganong ang imong mga tao wa may good water system, nag-experience man sila nganong walay tubig. So that requires, that demands a good political leadership. Mabit ang among kampanya ron boot street lang yun. Kaya maharap masolve ng problema ha.
Thank you very much. Can we now go to Liloan? How are you responding to the water crisis, if there is any for Liloan? Thank you.
Well, MCWD maintains 17 wells in Liloan, and we've had several conversations with them that they definitely could improve on the level of service that they are providing to Liloanons. We've tried to hold them accountable in this regard, this past administration. Second, as far as exploring our other options are concerned, I'm happy to let you know that Liloan, through our Sangguniang Bayan, has passed its local public-private partnership or PPP ordinance, and that will certainly open the doors for us to be able to explore better water management by partnering with private experts in this regard. This is something that we anticipate that we will be doing in the next few years. Third, our mountain barangays have very difficult access to water. In fact, we have one mountain barangay, Barangay Tabla, which is one of the highest peaks of Liloan, na wala gyud sila'y tubig since Liloan was founded as a municipality in the year 1845. So for almost 200 years, wala sila'y direct access to water. And knowing this, itong gibuhat, nagbuhat ta og communal water system para nila. And at the end of January this year, we were able to inaugurate 50 communal water faucets for the mountain barangay of Tabla. And we have also just finished two other water systems for our mountain barangays of Lataban and Mulao. And so where there was no previous direct access to water, karon na anay tubig ang atong mga kabarangayan sa Kabukiran.
Now,
I like to point out that of the three localities here, ang Danao ra dili misakop sa MCWD. Mm-hmm. So we have our own water district. So mao nang usa siguro lisod pod nga problema, kay kami may mukop sa among kaugalingon nga problema.
Mm-hmm. So you are suggesting that it should be also be part of the integrated approach.
Yes. Okay. Kay basic man siya, water, kaning traffic, garbage, yung imong waste management. Could be similar to Metro Manila Development Authority.
Let me go back a little bit to Liloan. With the developments now that you're putting up communal wells or water sources, had this eased the limitation of the access of households to drinking potable water?
Well, definitely this has eased the need for water. You know, something as simple as being able to have a bath. no? Something that we take for granted, no? Mabuhat na yung taon na dito sa atong mga mountain barangays. Usa sa DI sa atong gibuhat sa management of water is we passed a moratorium to prohibit further development of watersheds areas in Liloan, even those that are privately owned. So we were able to do that within this administration. We also continue to strictly implement our comprehensive land use plan, or CLUP, which provides various zones for Liloan. It's due for revision this year, and we're already in the workings of a working draft for a revised CLUP. So that has been very instrumental also in allowing the local government to ensure that there is sustainable development in Liloan. Lastly, it has been very important for us to forge forward with our programs on environmental sustainability, which is why we passed a Green Points Ordinance that actually provides a scorecard for businesses to implement environment-friendly measures such as the putting up of rainwater catchments in their facilities, permeable pavements, etc. The more environmentally friendly measures that they implement, the more green points that they're able to obtain, which they can then claim as discounts in our environmental fees. So not only have we tried to be strict with the implementation of our environment code, we've also tried to incentivize caring for the environment.
We're very much related to access to drinking water is access to water for irrigation because of climate change, El Nino here and there. Had there been efforts, very specific efforts to address climate change issues in your respective local government units? Sorry, Christina.
Well, caring for the environment is a cause that's very close to our heart, which is why under our administration, since the time of Mayor Duke Frasco, we've been able to plant no less than 110,000 trees in Liloan. And this garnered for us the award from the Ramon Aboites Foundation as an LGU engaging in best practices for the environment. We are also very aggressive as far as ensuring the preservation of our mangroves. And we have implemented our One Tree for Every Family program that requires all households in Liloan to plant at least one tree. You know, every little thing that we can do to help the environment, we are trying to do in Liloan, also through the implementation of our Purok system.
Anything else you want to add, Ma'am Thelma?
We have three, as regards the coastal resources, we have three, shall we say, what do we call that one? Disregarding the coastal resources, because this is also relates to climate change. Na ami gitawag na to o kanang sanctuary o nga maka-help gihapon nga instead ma dinyud natong seabed na tay three sanctuaries in poblacion Katarman and also in Calero, Marina Calero.
Yes, I think USC is planting somewhere in Liloan for our mangroves also. Yes. For Compostela, sir.
Ang problema na moron dito, rampant kayong quarrying. Even in the watershed areas.
And they were granted permits?
Muna yung problema na mo dito. Kung yung rampant, basig nagtuo ka nga daghang nag-quarry operators, usara sad. Kung usara yung mayolos amo, usara sa'yo nag-quarry dito.
Okay.
That's a fact. Okay? Unya, na-treaty na ang among watershed areas dito. So, if we speak of tree planting, waan na sa amo mauso? Ang nauso sa amo, quarrying. Ako, I did not bother to report to any government agencies. Kaya ang akong option, ang mga tao mismo. So, mga tao naghatag, mga tao sa imo bawi. I'd rather educate the people. Kung mukiha mo, kamo'y kiha. Kung mureport mo, kamo'y report. But I give them the opportunity to empower them during election day that you are the king of kings on that very day. Ang kanang inyong gibutan, mga sulugon, dana. No more power, no more abuse. Muna ang kampanya na mo, straight good.
That's the end time.
Okay na.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah. Because we are under one district. Now we have a very inspirational district leadership.
Okay.
So magbagong congressman, bago tanang mayor, bagong gobernador, vice gobernador, board members, niya among presidente, tanang kwari undang na.
Okay.
Nga, ang tanang damgo sa Mega Cebu, matuman na na.
Okay, we'll bank on that. No? Mr. Enriquez.
Yeah, please. For the now, usa sa kong giunaunaan, kay wala pa mong takalingkod, una, ang makumpleto ang geohazard mapping. So, ma-identify vulnerable areas. Then the council could pass the gitawag na LCCAP, no, the local climate change action plan. So makategorize ang action it either adaptive measures or mitigating measures. Duna na siya kuan, duna na set unsay mga defined as adaptive measures, unsay defined po as mitigating measures.
If I may ba, ang Danao City, ikaw, Liloan, na Attorney Christina Frasco, ang Danao is city, ang Liloan dili. Pero I'm sorry, kung tanaw nimo ang development sa lungsod, mas city pang Liloan kaysa Danao. Sa tinuod lang. O niya, kita, will be becoming local executives. Kanang ang programa nga efektibo na, mangupya na lang ta. Kung sa inas Liloan nga mayo, adapon sa Danao. Adapon sa Compostela. Sa ilang environmental programs, sa ilang health programs, amo na lang i-duplicate. O saragay dili na ako makopyas Liloan. Kaya ilang one town product nila, Roskilios man. Ang ako, collapsible baskets man, ukulilis. So, di mo may parehas.
Lain-lain mo raw materials.
Right, lain-lain mo yung panang featured product. Pero doon ay mga maayo kayong programa na nasa Liloan. I'm sorry, ngawa sa Danao. Di ba? Kaya ang Danao, silang ilang patubig, ilang kaugaling ng water district. Nalipay kayo ko nga inyong telepono na sakop ng Musglobe. Kay kamura unta dito gihap mo sa Danao, kamura yung magtinawganay dito sa telepono.
Kay long distance ang lain
nyo. Oh, di ba? So, mo na rin, something encouraging. O niya, karon ang presidente, taga Danao man na, niya, gipalayas man sa Danao, mabalik sa Danao para matuma na gito ang gitawag niya, kausaban yun para sa Danao o sa Tibu Kinto Distrito.
Okay. Diba?
Mo nang good street yun.
Atos ang papadayunon si Mr. Enriquez.
If I can just briefly...
Ay, patuyang na dali. Kaman sila man ni.
Sila na yung sige lalis to.
If I can just briefly respond lang yun, magpasalamat lang yun kay ko ni Mayor Richie, no? Duke Frasco is not here karon kay nasa gyud siya la input na commitments, pero malipayon kaayo mi na kung unsa pod ang iyang nabuhat ni Duke sa Liloan, nakita na gyud sa ato mga kaigsuunan sa Quinto Distrito, and ang hinaot sa gyud sila og kausaban para sa Quinto.
With all due respect, mayora, no, kay asawa man kang Mayor Duke, kung unsa nabuhat ni Mayor Duke sa Liloan og sa imo sad, magpasalamat kay mininyo. Kay nakanatao na ang inspirasyon sa Tibuok Distrito. Kanang taga Danao, dili man ang inspirasyonal.
Okay.
So, tinuod lang. Pero, pag mapulihan ha, kini. Kinadala kini, hulog ng langit ni. So, duha na akong saligan, Danao o Liloan. So, ako yung mapulihan aning tanan.
Niyato na pa sultihan si Mr. Enriquez.
Sige, sir. Aside ato, no, kay define man na siya katong mga events sa Conference of Parties, na mga international conventions, what are considered as the mitigating measures or adaptive measures for climate change. So, i-tick lang na siya. Ang usa ka importante is, I think, is katong yung sa makomplete ang geohazard mapping. So, we could be, it could be prevented katong mga medyo tragic nga mga hitabo, no? Nga nag-involve sa environment. Malikaya na na. It is a reality nga ang usa gyud ana ka contributing factor gyud is the extractive industries. So usa gyud na nga ma-regulate gyud, although sa Danao adunay mga quarrying pod, pero di naman kay ingon ana. But still, without the extractive industries, usay drivers for development bagod siya, mining, di na to malikayan in a developed country. Highly kanang nga mo involve yun og extractive industries. What I'm advocating would be responsible mining, responsible nga kaning og sustainable mining, because we have laws to that effect nga kaning mga sustainable practices. Di man sa tamingon nga ato gyud na ihunong. Kung ato ihunong sa unsa may alternative nga ato ang makuhaan for raw materials. So I think the bottom line there is for being responsible, sustainable, with, although do naman yung adverse effect to the environment, it cannot be denied. Mitigate, ma-minimize na to ang adverse effect to the environment.
Okay. We hate to actually wind up our discussion, but it's been an hour or so. And At this particular point, I'd like to request each one of you to give your closing message for 3 minutes. Attorney Christina?
Well, I'm very thankful for this opportunity to participate in the Mega Cebu Forum. 3 years ago, I participated in this exact same forum with lofty dreams and ideals for Liloan and with a hope for continuity. By the grace of God and with the support of Liloanons, ato nang napadayon ang kalambuan na nakabuot na sa Liloan o ato pong napalapdan. Nang hinaot ko na sa pagpadayon usab sa hugot kaayo na gugma o suporta sa akong makigsuon ng Liloanon na mapadayon pagyod nato o palambo pa atong lungsod hangtod na ato yung makabuot ang atong damgo isip usa ka malambuon na dakbayan dinhi sa Sugbo. Sa Quinto Distrito, mapasalamaton sa kaitas atong makigsuunan na naglantaw sa nabuhat na ni Duke Frasco dito sa Liloan. And we're so very grateful for everybody who has joined in this cause for change in the 5th District. Hopeful that ang atong mga programa sa education and health, patrabaho sa Liloan, ato po nang mapatagamtam dito sa Quinto Distrito through Duke Frasco. And to my fellow Liloanons, mapasalamaton sa kay koninyo sa inyong pagpadayon na pagsuporta o nang naot ko na mag-uban gihapon ta, meaning out atong kausa sa gugma o kalambuan. Live, love, Liloan.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Thelma. We're done.
Thank you very much for this forum. This is the first time nga naka-attend ko ingon ani. Being the head of the legislative body of the municipality, I say nga we support. The Sangguniang Bayan fully supports the administration of Mayor Christina Frasco, and we are one in her vision to improve more of Liloan. Kay as I see it, ang Liloan karon mura ni bulak nga nag-anam nagkabuklad ta kaninot nag-anam kagwapa para sa among mayor. So with that, I would like to say nga thank you very much and also to the Liloanons, daghan kay salamat, and I hope we will continue working together as a team.
Thank you very much. Compostela, Mr. Richie Wallace.
Muna sa tanan, salamat sa Mega Cebu nining kay gayon nga gihatag o sa tanan nga nagsunod ni imong programa. Ako malipayon nga mupaybaw sa tanan nga we had been fighting for the restoration of genuine democracy and freedom in our country. In fact, not to blow my own horn, I was part in the 1986 revolution. Nagpalagpot na itong usa ka salbay sa diktador. But sad to note and sad to say, hangtod karon ang iyang mga kabilin sa diktadurya, buhi pas Danao. And we are still fighting until now. Okay? Kining tanan ng mga development goals sa Mega Cebu, matuman lang ni, kung madismantle na namo ang mga kabilin sa diktadurya, kanang gitawag og recycled leadership, kanang tagawag namo abusive dynasty. Mahuman na lang unta na para matagaan og bagong inspirasyon, bagong liderato ubos ni Congressman Duke Frasco. Kay musugutag sa dili, the kind of leaders that we have will reflect the kind of people we are. So I hope nga magmata na ang taga-Quinto Distrito. Nasa kanta pa ang takot ay nasa isip lamang. So panahon na ron sa bag-o, panahon na ron sa maayo, ang sikat na ron dili na Danao, taga-Liloan na mga inspiration sa tibok Quinto Distrito. Muna ang among kampanya sa Liloan, hantod sa Bourbon, hantod sa Camotes Island. Maghari na ang gahom sa katawhan, maghari na ang kagawasan. Muna gikan ni Digong hangtod sa katapusan konsehal, Boat Street yung tanan. Hindi pilaban wan Cebu.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wagas. Mr. Enriquez.
Allow me to use the kwan ha. Ang tanang butang doon ay sinugdan, doon na gyoy katapusan. Bisan pa diha sa pagagamhanan, ako mituo ng Ginoo nga akong gituhuan, siya ang mipabarug ug bupukan sa mga gingharian. Sa kasaysayan nakita na nato. Ug kami nangandoy nga dunay kausaban diha sa among dakbayan sa Danao. Una, diha sa mga health services. Nga unta makadagamtam diha sa to ang Danao wala siya yung kagalingon nga hospital unlike Cebu City, Mandawi. Usa sa among nakita mao nga ang ato agayod mismo nga mga kaigsuunan makagamit sa Cebu Provincial Hospital with the agreement with the kuan po niya, provincial government nga dunay 200 beds man na, dunay pipila ka mga beds ana nga i-reserve gyud alang sa mga danawanon. Ug ang taga Danao mismo maoy kami may mo gasto kay di man makapatukod sa mga galingon nga hospital, mahal man og butukod kag hospital. That health services nga matagamtam po sa tong mga senior citizen. Nga mong senior citizen makadawat dili kay 70 anyos, kun dili 60 anyos makadawat og katong mga hinabang subsidy gikan sa to ang gobyerno sa Danao. Dito sa Danao 1,500 ray ang mga dawat sa mga senior citizen nga nagpagidarog si Tinta. Pero sa Liloan 4,000 ang ilang madawat. Ang Liloan o sa lamang kalungsod, ang Danao o sa kasyudad. Ngaon niya ang atong mga kaigsuunan nga danawanon dili na unta manrabaho gawas sa Danao. Kay diha sa Danao mismo wala may mga industriya kaayo nga natukod. Mao na nga usap pud namo nga gipangandoy nga unta mabukas, maabli ang atoang syudad sa Danao ngadto sa industriya nga makatagamtam usab og maka introduce og mga panginabuhian. Gamay na lang akong time, ako na lang dalion. Lastly nga unta dili na magpagahom diha sa kakuyaw, kahadlok diha sa mga pagpanghulga. Panahon na karon alang sa kausaban. Ug ang kausaban dili magasukad diha sa uban. Kausaban magasukad diha sa imuhang kaugalingon. If you believe in real change and if you persist that it will happen, then it will happen. The only way for evil to triumph is for good men to do nothing. Daghang salamat.
Thank you very much. So at this particular point, atong i-review ang inyong mga commitments. We will see at the back screen per candidate. So actually, while nag-discuss ta, naatay one-man team at the back, no? Si Miss Eileen Mangubat. She was able to capture each and everything that you actually committed. Okay, let's start with Attorney Christina Frasco. Vision: Liloan on the cusp of cityhood, aims to be the premier city in Cebu with sustainable and inclusive growth, continue focus on education and health. Challenge is fastest population growth. In terms of traffic, there is a 1 billion port project of Liloan that will decongest roads with new ferry system. Cebu needs strong leadership in province to rally mayors. In terms of water, press MCWD 17 wells for better service. PPP ordinance will open doors to explore other sources. And in the area of environment, CLUP is due for revision. There is a Green Points ordinance offering incentives for rainwater catchments, etc., for the business sector. For EJK and drug war, Operation Second Chance offers community service to offenders, balance enforcement with rehabilitation. Liloan is champion in drug abuse council recognized by the capital. And relations with capital dismayed with Liloan's provincial roads in despair despite repeated follow-ups. Everything okay? Yeah, water system in the mountain barangays. There were 50 faucets that were open and wells. All right. We will add that into the documentation. Now let's go to the next candidate, Ma'am Thelma Jordan, Vice Mayoral Candidate for Liloan. Continue legislative gains in terms of traffic commission, the traffic code, commission for women and children, the market code, sanitation code, among others. The municipal council will reinforce the agenda of Mayor Frasco, and in the area of environment, continue mangrove sanctuaries. Are there other things that you would like to add? Okay, perfect. Can we now go to the next candidate? For Mr. Richie Wagas, mayoral candidate of Compostela, liberate the district from the 70-year-old dynasty, from recycled leaders. In the area of water, why is only 20% of town for Compostela served by MCWD when Compostela has a watershed, I think, no? Politics holds back system. in terms of water provision. Rampant quarrying by one entity should be replaced. Favors a metro-wide body for traffic management. Copy the successful programs of Liloan, which is more of a city than Danao. That's on record. EJK and drug war. I still believe in the rule of law. And relations with capital, I don't expect anything good from them. All right. Do we have one more? Okay. For Mr. Michael, and by the way, Sir Richie, anything else you want to add to the list?
Okay,
Nato. Okay, very good. Michael Enriquez. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Vote straight.
He has repeated that a number of times in his in all of his appeals, so we have to include that. Vote straight. For Mr. Michael Enriquez, Vice Mayoral Candidate, Danao City, replace one family rule in Danao. In the area of traffic, improve habal-habal safety and service. For water supply, review bulk water contract of MCWD Ayala to give local residents first priority in service. Environment, finish geohazard mapping of Danao. For EJK and drug war, some deaths are legitimate police operations. In the area of relations with capital, no improvement seen in Danao Provincial Hospital. Senior citizens should get more assistance. From 70, it should be recognized at 60. And open Danao to more industries. Anything else you want to add, sir?
Yes, on the part of traffic, I made mention about arterial roads connecting northern Cebu to the western part.
And the circumferential road.
Yes. Aside from the circumferential road, because that would only be on the coastal access,
yes.
The arterial going to the interior portion.
So then, we will add that.
Then second, as to water supply, I made mention about maintenance of watershed areas, because in Danao, we don't have
maintenance of watershed area.
Then
yes, sir.
On the aspect of the environment, I made mention about responsible and sustainable mining regarding environment, not only regarding geohazard mapping,
anywhere.
To complete the geohazard mapping, but also to about responsible and sustainable mining or the extractive
responsible
industry.
And sustainable mining.
Then I also made mention in under environment regarding the passage of the local climate change action plan with respect to the definitions of mitigating and adaptive measures as that defined in the conference of parties, because there were mentions about it. Then I think that's it. Then on AGK, drug war, I think I also made mention that the legitimate police operation should not be confused with AGK, because sometimes they would equate that the police operation, that amounts to AGK already.
Okay.
So they have to distinguish. And also regarding therapeutic
programs,
because we also made mention that although I believe that a man is basically good, so the therapeutic programs.
Yeah.
Relations with capital, I think that's it. And open the Natomar. That's it.
Thank you very much.
The last one.
Yes. Ma'am Thelma here.
Sagurian is full support to Mayor Cristina Pascos. Programs and projects.
Yes, full support of Sangguniang Bayan to Mayor Frasco's programs and projects. Okay, so our candidates are actually signing up to the Bugsay as part of their commitment. Yes, one more?
Open the now to
more industries. So at this particular point, we would like to thank our candidates. Can we give them a very resounding round of applause? Thank you very much for lighting up our afternoon and for gracing our occasion. So while Mr. Enriquez is signing up, may I request all our candidates for a photo opportunity. Maing hapon sa tanan. This is our second set for this afternoon's Klarohay Ta. Naruhon jud dinato Mega Cebu Candidates Forum 2019. This is not the first, but this is actually the third run of the Mega Cebu Candidates Forum. They have started doing the Candidates Forum in 2013, quite exclusive to Mega Cebu, an audience for businessmen, technocrats and the like. In 2016, they opened it up to the public. But in 2019, they see the need for other institutions and other sectors to be involved. And particularly that sector is the academe, since we can bring together a host of students and young people who are actually in the university and even online. So our Mega Cebu Candidates Forum this year is entitled Klarohay Ta. This is to set the record straight, both not only for candidates, but also with our voters. Cebuano voters are tagged to be intelligent voters, but it's history who will judge whether or not we really are one. But more importantly, we would like to provide a platform, a venue for our candidates to engage directly with our voters. And with a 21st century, our voters are not just physical voters that you can see sitting down in your rallies and sorties, but they are online. And it is for such reason that we partner with MyTV, Channel 30 in Sky Cable, so we can bring this discussion to as wide a population as possible. Before I call in the candidates, I'd like to remind the four of them that our discussion will circle around the themes of Mega Cebu. In particular, one, we will be talking about transport and traffic management. Next, road improvement and infrastructure development. We will also have some questions on health, sanitation, and waste management, environmental management, also on public safety, metropolitan management or inter-LGU collaboration and coordination, and cultural heritage preservation and tourism. So without further ado, I would like to call in our candidates. So they'll be seated here, and once everybody's here, they will have their opening message. For the 5th Legislative District Representative candidate, Mr. Red Durano, from Nationalist People's Coalition. Following him, Vice Mayoral Candidate of Liloan from Bacod, Mr. Jimmy Maglasang. Another candidate, Mayoral Candidate for Compostela from Bacod, Mr. Froilan Quino. And the Rose Among the Thorns, Vice Mayoral Candidate of Compostela from Bacod Party, Ms. Josephine Abin. Can we give our candidates a round of applause? Great. Thank you very much. So we have our electronic timer in front of you. You're given 3 minutes to actually give your opening message. Shall we start with Sir Red?
Thank you, Ma'am Burnett. Thank you for the invitation this afternoon. This would give me an opportunity and the rest of our candidates of Bacod Party to shed light on issues that are present this time. And I would like to take this opportunity also to thank the constituents of the 5th District for their continued trust and support for my candidacy. They have given me 4 terms as representative of the 5th District, and I'm thankful for their trust and support. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can we now go to Mr. Maglaso?
Dahang salamat, ma'am. On my part, akong being the vice mayoral mayoral candidate of Liloan, Cebu, I was elected for barangay council, barangay captain, and then for my 3 terms of barangay captain, I implemented projects and programs for our barangay, and then kung unsay akong ibuhat sa akong barangay, ako sandad only to sa among lungsod to kanang improve, and then to give more project and development para sa among lungsod as Vice Mayor of Municipality of Liloan. Thanks, salamat.
Thank you very much. Next on, Mr. Froilan Quino.
Good afternoon to all the audience presently here and also sa among pinalanggang lungsod nga nasa live stream karon nagtan-aw. Mayong hapon kaninyong tanan. Ako si Froilan Quino, magpapili isip kandidato sa lungsod sa Compostela karong umaabot May 2019 election. Since I am new on this position, I would like to give a brief background of myself. I am presently the barangay captain of Barangay Poblacion, Compostela, Cebu. And I am also a graduate of BS Accountancy. And also, at the same time, the president of the Liga ng Mga Barangay sa Compostela, Cebu. As to my plans and dreams of Compostela, the present administration have greatly improved our status of the Compostela in terms of infrastructure and other programs. Ang ako lang ikasulti in general, kung unsa ang nindot nga nasugdan sa present administration, ako kining padayunon ug akong palambuon. Ug unsa pagyud ang kulang, I will check all the needed documents, papers to make Compostela a better place from what it is today. Thank you and good afternoon.
Thank you very much. Ma'am Josephine Abing.
Good afternoon sa atong mga kaigsunan nga na tanaw karon sa ilang TV, sa Facebook, with the rest of the candidates now. And thank you for the organizers for giving us the opportunity to be around. At least the constituents of Compostela are well guided for the right choice on this May 13 elections. At first, I will introduce myself. I'm Josephine T. Abing. Historic experience, I have been the Sangguniang Bayan member of the municipality for the past 15 years and a vice mayor for 12 years. And this year, May 13, election, this could be my last term. So, if given the privilege, as I did in my last vice mayorship with the past two mayors, I've been a supporter to the agenda of the executive with the aim and goal is really for the development of our municipality. With that note, thank you and good afternoon to each and everyone.
Daghang salamat, no? At this particular point, maybe you can share so far, how is your campaign going? No? Maybe we can start with the local and then we'll go to the district. So, who wants to start? Ma'am Abing? Kumusta ang pagpangampanya?
Ang pagkumpanya ba, diligid ka ng sayon? We have to reach the people. Well, giilhan naman me, but they have to know nga, we are running for the position. Kaya nguban yun, duwa mang good kahibaw kung mudagan mabaka, kung insay-say mudagan, other the bakod man mi ma'am and the performance team. So, amula i-present what are the issues, valid issues that we need to answer, and what are then our programs, plans, and programs if given the privilege to win in this May 13 elections. So, nanikamot ragyud mi, bro, every minute of the day, murag yung big challenger. Kaya ang election, di man na siya basketball nga, nairibansi. If ever you fail, really fail. So that's all.
Dagang salamat. Sir, Froilan.
As what Vice Mayor have shared, it is not easy to do the campaign. It will take a lot of your time, effort, and even patience. Kaya na yung mga tao nga, moingon ni mo usahay o dili kayo nindot nga words. So, you have to do the best that you can just to inform them of your platforms, unsay imong plano sa lungsod, unsay makaayo para nila. So, keep those negative comments aside. Positive lang. Positive vibes. That's all, ma'am. Thank you.
Dagang salamat, Sir Jimmy.
So sa amo sa Liloan, ma'am, being kami mga challenger, so daghan yung kayo mga propaganda sa gani ang administrasyon, where in fact ang kami naninguha lang po dog maayo to counter. But on our part, dili sayon no ang pag convince o mga tao in relation for voting. But kami naninguha, amo lang yung gipadayag nila kung unsay mga issue nga gibuhat karon sa administrasyon o unsa usay kuwang among punan o unsay dili maayo pagka-implementar nga sistema, amo kanang usbon. Now, kami maninguha, pagpadayag lang yun kung unsay mga eksakto in relation to sa mga health and medical services, kung unsay kuwang among tarungon o gunya in relation to allowances or sa mga grants for the senior citizen, amo ka ng gipadayag na amo ka ng hatagan sa eksakto fairly ang tanan o ang sa scholarship grant, amo sa gipadayag nila nga patas ang paghatag ni ana in relation to environment, mag-create sa mga sanitary landfill para sa munisipyo o gunya in relation to sa among pagpangagni, amo pag yung gipadayag nila nga mag encourage tag mga investors without any monetary consideration. So manay among pagpadayag nila o gunya other thing is ang development, amo yung gipasabot nilang we have to kuan establish kinini ang a commercial centers, a reclamation project. Yeah, at the same time, for the students, for the indigenous students, we are planning to establish a CTU Liloan. Thank
okay.
you, ma'am.
Dagang salamat. Congressman Red.
Thank you. I'm in agreement with all, no, nga dili lalim mga panya, especially on my part, where I campaign for the entire district. That's 10 towns and one city and 207 barangays all in all. Especially now nga time of election, ang mga tao paraygon kayo, which is understandable because of course they want to improve their quality of life. And for me, being a public servant, being an elected official, I think that's the main purpose of being elected, is to improve the quality of the lives of the of your constituents. And going around, I see varied problems. Each municipality has its own problems. Each barangay in each municipality has its own problems. So as a public servant, as an elected official, you have to be aware of those problems, and you must be ready to address those problems head on. And that's what I'm offering the people of the 5th District of Cebu. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You have had positions in government prior to for this particular election, maybe in different capacity. But what do you think will be or had been the most challenging problem of the 5th District and for each of your municipality that actually drove you to decide to actually seek position once again or in a different capacity? So unsa man tong mga challenging kaayong labad sa ulo sa inyuhang tagsa-tag sa KLG yung nakaaghat ninyo to actually seek position this election? Ma'am Abing, we can start with you.
Okay, thank you. For me, ma'am, is the really the very challenging now on my part is the promotion of tourism in our municipality. Because can I elaborate?
Yes, please.
Okay, because we have for now the Camino de Santiago Compostela, which is now a replica of Spain. We started a project that was July of 2016. When the 10-day walk was done by the mayor and the parish priest. So our very vision is that we can come up with a pilgrimage of Camino de Santiago, a replica of Spain, because we are so privileged that our Compostela is also the patron is Santiago Compostela. Not unlike other municipalities have the patron of Santiago, but they are not Compostela. Ours is Compostela. So the God's grace, wherever to establish the project, that was July 2016. So the mayor, and that is a collaborative project between the state and the church. So the mayor with the parish priest, the first drought was in Badian, considering Badian is the oldest Santiago parish. So they talk the 10 days walk. So after the 10 days, the last day is the opening salvo of our Santiago feast. So last February 6, that is a very historical event in the municipality of Compostela, because a chancellor from Spain, from Community Santiago, Spain, was in Compostela bringing the relics of Santiago. It is now placed on our altar. And on that day, the Bond of Affinity was signed by the Camino de Santiago Compostela with Camino de Santiago, Spain. So we have now the replica of kanang pilgrimages. So we envisioned Compostela would be a center of religious tourism in Asia.
Okay, so that's what you what you want. That's your agenda. All right. Can we have Sir Froilan?
There was a time that I'm still engaged in private companies. The main problem that I encounter is first the livelihood o panginabuhian sa mga tao. Even involved ko o private company, it will just, in a week I will receive 4 or 5 biodatas trying to apply for a job. After that, I realized that I have to do something. So when there was a slot during 2010 for me to be a part of the Bakod, I mean not the Bakod, a part of a team in our barangay, I offered myself to be elected as barangay councilor during 2010. First time that I offered myself, I was ranked as second highest in the barangay council. Then after that, the people experience a different kind of pamalakad sa barangay. We do purok visitation. I'm carrying with my a doctor with medicine and other item that I can bring to the people. Since then, they have experienced a different kind of governance. Then when I run for a higher position as the currently punong barangay, I win in a landslide victory due to that change. And now the party has offered me the mayor position, so I still grab because I believe as young as I am, I can do so much to help the community. That's all, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Sir Jimmy.
Ang nagkapaghat yun ako, ma'am, no, sa pagpadayon, sa pagpapili o paglansar kay tungod sa kining atong passion to serve, no, sa mga kaigsunan ako diya sa akong asamong municipality, asamong barangay. But being a barangay captain and also a municipal councilor 2004, and then ang pinakalisod, no, pagdumala mao ang being a barangay captain in kuan kanang in a first class municipality kay dako magud ang population sa among barangay. Now being a little mayor, so of course kami is being an instrument sa paghatag og mga kanang benepisyo ngadto sa mga kaigsunan, and then we are also an instrument for development, for change para sa among present administration. So mo na nga among damgo, among gi akong damgo nga unta mapadagan ang maong lungsod nga sa kinabus nga pamaagi nga uwid kana na ang proper kanang ingon ta paglantaw para sa tinuod nga kalambuan sa among pinalanggang lungsod sa Liloan.
Dagang salamat, Congressman Red.
Thank you. For me, it's more of continuing a legacy of public service left by my late grandfather Ramon Durano Sr. my background, educational background, is in business. When I got the opportunity to run in 2005, I was a reluctant candidate. But while growing up, I see the family as being there for the people. No matter what time it is, we're there to help the people, election time or not, we're there. And when the opportunity came, I took it as a challenge to continue that legacy of public service that was left by my grandfather. So I believe that the projects and the programs that I am advocating now as Congressman of the 5th District reflect that legacy of public service to the people of the 5th District of Cebu. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I'd like to brush a little bit on the choice of group or team or band. Na-mentioned ganina ni Sir Froilan that you were invited by Bakod, no? And all of the candidates here belong to Bakod Party. Is there any tatak Bakod that made you actually join Bakod? Especially that Congressman Red here is talking about a long legacy of public service from a particular brand, which is Durano brand, which I will ask in a little while. So may I ask Ma'am Abing and Sir Froilan and Sir Jimmy, why Bakod? What's with Bakod?
We are with Bakod because we believe in the party. And the leaders of Bakod are really into service. Unlike other leaders, that they are just good on campaigning, but on the actual action na on service, this la makitaan. So as to the infra now, the developments now of our municipality, had it not of our leaders, the higher one in Bakod, we cannot deliver. Because third municipality as we are, if you are just very dependent on Aurera is only 124 million. We cannot undertake such developments that we have now. So I reiterate, we believe in their good leadership. That is public service.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Josephine. Yes, Sir Froilan.
As what Vice Hub said, we believe in the leadership of Congred and his family and the Bakod Party as a whole. Bakod Party stands for good governance, kind-hearted people, strong leadership, and at the same time, a mentor to the new leaders growing up on how to build a nation, how to build a comfortable place to live in. So we believe on that. In other terms, they say that same birds flock together, same feathers flock together. So birds of sakto ba? So in general, in one term, we have the same vision. We have the same kind of style in leadership, which is in general for the betterment of our constituents and to improve each lives in our area that we are handling. That's all.
Thank you, sir. Can we have Sir Jimmy?
Being on the Bakod, ma'am, ako lang nang i-guan. Ang Bakod is barug alang sa kauswagan o demokrasya. Now, being a Bakod family, kami sa among bahin, kanang we are really kanang confident, no, sa among makuha o among mapaambit sad ngadto sa among mga constituents. Kay mostly sa akong barangay, kayuan man jud kaay ko. So natural, being a public official, kinahanglan resourceful yun ta. Muna nga, mogin na importante kayo nga bisag anytime, anywhere, kung kinsay atong madangpan, mangayo kita for kanang development niya. One thing sa among Bakod family is we really respect, no, sa unsay kanang mission and vision sa maong kanang partido. Huwag niya, wala joy mabilin ang tanan kanang tabangan og dadon yud for better nga kuan constituents ug unya ang imuha sang barangay o lungsod matagaan sa duwi eksakto nga support and assistance.
Daghan kay salamat. Ang Bakod Manggod is one of the longest political party locally that has a long history. So we'll ask Congressman Red. He was talking about the legacy of leadership, of public service. Sir, if we may ask, how long, if you can put into numbers the length of time the Duranos have been serving the 5th District, unsa nakadugay, sir?
Well, I believe my grandfather started in public service right after the war.
Okay.
Okay, I believe around 1948 or 1949. I'm not sure about the dates, but yeah, so it was after the war.
Mga 70 anyos na ang mga Duranos.
Yes.
And how do you think the Duranos had kept pace with the development of the 5th District and the entire Cebu?
Well, like I said earlier, we're very sensitive to the needs of the people. And for public officials to discount that, that's their demise. And on our part, we're very sensitive to the needs of the people. And we reflect our programs and our services to address those needs. And importantly, we put the interest of the people first before our own. And I believe that's the reason why after all this time, we still have the trust and the confidence of the people of Danao City and the entire 5th District of Cebu.
Now let's go to the different themes of Mega Cebu and let us try to see how the incumbents would like to or have had strides already in achieving these themes, and for the newbies, what are your plans in relation to these themes? And perhaps we can paint a picture of how this particular type of brand or leadership is able to articulate these plans into actions. Let's start with transport and traffic management. No? Going to the north, it's impossible not to pass by Liloan, Compostela, and Danao City. No? In fact, choke points are found in these areas. No? Mayon ganitag 1 hour ang Danao from the city, pero ano mo duha man sa kauras tungod sa traffic, no? So unsa man ang mga programa nga nasugdan na, for example, sa mga incumbents, for Vice Mayor Abing, siguro si Congressman Red can share also. And what are the plans that you have in place for Sir Froilan and Sir Jimmy, should you be given the chance? Ma'am Abing?
As far as traffic and transport is concerned, for now, we have a reclamation area that is 2 hectares, and the plan now is that could be alternate road going to Laplapo, considering adaghan kay nanarbaho sa Laplapo, yan naa sila magkaon sila kanang duha sila kanang sakay. So from their place, munaog sila Liloan, sakay multicab going to Laplapo. So that could be a possible kanang alternate or possible option that di maka-avoid sila sa traffic. For in fact, there are many companies now coming for a negotiation. That so the possibility would be a ferry from Compostela to Laplapo, then another ship going to Camutis from Compostela.
Okay, so that's a different ferry,
yeah, different
system.
Ferry.
Okay. From Compostela.
That could be an option.
Okay.
To address the traffic.
So you are looking into that project?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have already your private partner for that, or that's still in the pipeline?
There are private partners coming, but we did not go the final negotiation yet.
Okay.
Because we are still on the process of further developing the area.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.
Si Congressman Red, as incumbent, no? Unsay mga programa bahin sa traffic?
Well, I agree with you now that just coming here from Danao, it took me 2 hours. Before, while I was studying, 40 minutes stops. Well, one thing I addressed was the roads, no, going to the north. As you, if you've been traveling to the north recently, the national highway has been widened. And that's what we're working on now. In fact, right now in Danao, construction is going on for the widening of those roads. So from two lanes, it's now to four lanes. Aside from that, we're trying to develop alternate routes aside from the national highway. In fact, there's a route now we're trying to develop with the provincial government from Compostela, going to the mountains of Compostela, and you end up in Talamban. So we're trying to develop that route just to bypass the main highway. Aside from that, I co-authored various bills in Congress to address traffic management in our metropolitan cities. No, this is House Bill 6425, an act prescribing an urgent comprehensive land-based traffic management policy to effectively address the traffic congestion crisis in Metro Manila, Metro Cebu, and Metro Davao.
Thank you very much. No, it's interesting to know that there are pending bills in Congress to that effect. So I have here a set of questions that can be answered by yes or no, and then you're given a minute to justify your yes or no. Should the Constitution be amended, will you support for an extended term for local officials? So 3 years, more than 3 years? So will you support for an extended term for local officials? Can we have Ma'am Abby a yes or no, and then a 1 minute justification?
Yes.
Yes.
Extension is good for those who are performing. I would just hope that if given the privilege to have another trust and confidence this election, so since there are some other plans and programs, I believe that within the 3 years term it cannot be completed. So another 3 terms is needed for the accomplishment, because if a plan is half-baked, you cannot expect full service and satisfaction as what you aim to do. That's all.
Thank you very much. Sir Froilan.
For me, the terms is not the question. For me the question is the elected official doing his job or not? If he is doing his job, so it is so nice to say that we extend his term. But if he is not doing his job as what he is trusted by the people, we might cut his term. better give a shorter term for that guy. So for me, it is really on the performance of the candidate or the elected official. In general, we should continue what is good.
Okay.
But anything bad should be stopped right away.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sir Jimmy.
On my part, ma'am, I support to extend term by 5 years, but two terms only.
So a total of 10.
A total of 10. Now, para maiyag yung himo ang iyahang mga plano o mga damgo para sa iyahang lungsod, kay nasayod man ta nga ang 3 years dool ra gyud kaayo. Now, we better extend for another 2 years, but limited of 2 terms. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Congressman Red?
I'm perfectly fine with the way things are. The only thing about a 3-year term is if you're a newbie. Because once you're new, it takes time to learn the ropes, and before you know it, your term is almost done. But on the good side, if there are officials that are not performing to par or up to the expectations of their constituents, then that particular constituency can replace that particular public official. So I believe as it is now, it's working for the country.
Thank you very much. Another 1 minute challenge. Is honesty a valid campaign issue? Yes or no? And then your 1 minute justification. Ma'am Abing?
For me, honesty is really
is next to godliness, di ba? So you've got to be honest in your dealings, for as said, you're accountable to your actions. So just be honest, even if others are not. Even if others will not. But you must be honest, because honesty is the best policy.
Okay. Thank you very much. Sir Froyland, please.
Same with Vice Mayor. Honesty is still the best policy, as taught during our grade 1. So that's the basic rule in our society. So for me, honesty should not be questioned. It should be part of the criteria of being a public servant. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Sir Jimmy.
For me, mas maayo good ma'am nga honesta in relation to sa poor good governance, and then honesta sa atong gisaad sa atong mga constituents nga ato nang buhaton, then honesta sa kining mga areas nga dunay mga hangyo nga sometimes kanang maglisod ta og hatag, but kinahanglan gyud nga atong ipadayag, no, kung unsay tinuod. Thank you.
Thank you. Congressman Red.
Yes, I believe that honesty should be honesty should constituents should look at honesty as part of a requirement for their candidate. And I believe that the constituency should demand it from their candidates, from their public officials. After all, what we're holding is a public trust, and we're accountable to the people we serve. So I believe honesty is important.
Okay, this is the third 1 minute challenge. Is political dynasty an issue of the 5th district? Ma'am Abing?
Political dynasty. It is really a known fact that Duranos really led the 5th district. So as far as political dynasty is concerned, it's really in existence. But political dynasty is not a question. If the leaders are chosen by the people and they are performing well to deliver the best for the constituents. Political dynasty is only bad if those people chosen or the leaders within the dynasty are not performing well, or they are abusive of their powers. But as I can see on the Duranos within the dynasty, they are performing well and good leaders, and they are servant leaders.
Okay, thank you very much. Sir Froyland.
In real sense, I don't think there is dynasty, because all our elected officials pass an election. They are voted by the people. The people were not forced, were not pinpointed by a gun to vote for them. They have voted on their own will. So if these guys were elected by the majority of the people, I think it's the voice of the people that has been heard and accepted by the majority. So it's not a question of dynasty. It's the question if these guys elected are doing, performing their jobs, and they are honest on their tasks. That's the main question here. It's not the family name who's been elected at the same time, the same family. It's the performance on the job that they have trusted by the people.
Okay, thank you very much. Sir Jimmy.
For me, ma'am, a dynasty is not an issue in 5th District, but rather I prepare it as a privilege, no, sa with the Duranos nga to rin, no, sa maonga distrito, because of course doon na may other person who are willing and gusto nga mo serbisyo, but ang mga tao is they are already on their mind nga kisay ilang ang ayan nga pilion. But for me, I choose for the Bakod family, not just a dynasty. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Jimmy. Congressman Red.
Ma'am Burnett, at the end of the day, it's the people who decide who their elected officials are. And like myself, I went through every election with an opponent. So I'm just fortunate that I and my family still have the support and trust of the people. And I believe that's the key here, is do you have the trust and support of the people? Now, like I said in my opening statement earlier, we're sensitive to the needs of the people, and we put their interests before us. That's why our family lasted this long, because we continue to have the trust, and each family member who is in office, they know for a fact that the position we have now is borrowed. It's not permanent. So we are accountable to the people, and we are answerable to the people. So if you don't serve the people, then you don't have the right to be there. So that's all I have to say. I know a lot of people are throwing this against us, but for me, it's not an issue, because what we are offering is a brand of service that is tried, tested, and trusted. So I don't think this is an issue in the 5th District of Cebu.
Thank you very much. I'm down to the second to the last question. With all the plans that you have in mind and all the plans that you have already started for the 5th District and each of your LGUs, collaboration is key. Because working alone in Compostela, in Liloan, and even for the 5th District without looking at the neighboring districts, your plans are futile. So what are your thoughts about pursuing collaboration, and how willing are you to collaborate with other districts and even other LGUs within the district and other neighboring LGUs?
As far as collaboration is concerned, this is really a need for every LGU. More specifically sa among, we are just a third class municipality. So being a member of Mega Cebu, we are that privilege. When in fact, when it comes to collaboration, please be known that we have a deputized traffic enforcers. Environmental enforcers. And they were trained by Mandawi City Centro, Mr. Flas. And we owe that to them, kay they really spare time to do that. For in fact, the training was made good dito sa among Compostela. So, collaboration is really, I reiterate, is really a need. Kay masayon ang trabaho kung daghan mo tabang. Kay no man is an island, you need everybody's effort for your realization of your goals.
So thank you very much, Sir Froilan.
Based on history, Compostela was once part of Danao, then became a city of Liloan. So in short, we are one family before. So for me, it is really important to work as a team with the neighboring towns and or municipalities. This is similar to the barangay. Since I am a barangay captain of population, I have to coordinate also with my neighboring barangays. There are situations, there are programs that you need to cooperate with them so it will be much, much more effective, like the tanod, what do you call this, kaning magkuan magabi iba, magsuroy-suroy just to maintain peace and order. So we need to have a proper cooperation and teamwork with the neighboring barangays, similar to also with the towns in the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Sir Jimmy.
So, for me, that is very important, ma'am, in relation to collaboration with the LGU. Kay ana na to makita. And then, ana pod mo kanang ma-come up ang success for the entire Mega Cebu. Importante good ang collaboration with the LGU.
So you will have to work with others.
Yes.
And Congressman Red.
As representative of the 5th District, I'm always in support of our local executives. Whatever their plans are for their particular municipalities, I'm always there to support them. And I'm happy that municipalities in my district are there to help one another. And that's, I'm proud to say that that's one reason why the towns in the 5th District of Cebu are very progressive, because they learn from each other. And that's my vision as the representative of the 5th District, that there's unity among all the local executives there so that they can move forward and improve their municipalities without thinking about politics. No, and I think that's the common vision here of our candidates from Bacud, is for their municipalities and their constituencies to prosper.
Okay. I'm down to my last question. This is quite a comic question. If you get elected and you get to, or re-elected, and you get to have a speaking time with President Duterte for half an hour, but you have to answer it in 2 minutes. what would you ask him, or what would you tell him? Ma'am Abby, you know na pa yung 30-minute speech with President Duterte.
Ay, their actions as to the speaking manner of Duterte. As a leader, he's a good leader. Pero in uttering words, you have to choose words. Okay, kung ma-utter na good na nimo, di naman na nimo baboy. Because I said nga, the damage has been done. So, ang imo sang istorya, depende sa nasa imong audience. So, how you have to act appropriately in the right time and the proper place. That's all.
Okay, on record, we can send this to President Duterte. Sir Froilan.
As of this time, I'm still thinking of what to say to President Duterte.
Okay.
But honestly, first, I would like to thank him for the effort. For there is a massive changes in our, basically in our barangay or in our town, due to his drive to rehabilitate those infected by these vices. It's really a great sigh of relief sa mga commuters, ordinary citizens, nga wala na kaayoy mag-standby-standby sa Dublin-Dublin. So first, I would like to thank him for that. Second is, I also will ask advices from him, because he's been in politics, in public servant for a very long time. I would like to ask also his kind of leadership, his strategies, and also, since I'm still single, and Mr. President is known to be good on woman, so I will also ask advices on how to have a partner in life. Thank you.
Sir President, yun yung pumunta na sa iyong partner in life. Anyway, thank you very much. Can we have Sir Jimmy?
On my part, I congratulate first with the president in relation to implementing for the drug related activities na yaging work out, no, to ma-eradicate ang drug problem. And then I would also request him in relation to sa the effect of the inflation. So para nako is mas maayo nga mas nadihan gyud ang kining sa economic managers ang result ong ang effect sa inflation nowadays, kay tanaw nako ang pobre in town mosamot og ka pobre kay lagi tungod anang mga other taxes na gi-implement no sa atong gobyerno. So ang napiktahan ang mga yano lungsuranon. So that's all, ma'am. Thank you.
Daghang salamat, Congressman Red. I suppose you have had conversations with the president.
No, actually no.
Okay, so
but if I have I had the chance, I would say, Mr. President, how do you do it? I mean, obviously there's a lot I could learn from him. With all the controversies thrown at him, he still enjoys the support of the majority of the Filipinos, and the way he won the presidency was very unprecedented. No one expected him to win, but yet here he is now. occupying the most powerful position in the land, and continues to be supported by a majority of the Filipinos. Obviously, he's politically wise, and being a public servant, I have a lot to learn from him. So if I get one chance to ask him anything, I would say, how did you do it?
We can actually show the video of today's session. Maybe he will reply you in different ways. Yeah. So I really hate to wind this up because we've had a very good conversation. But I'd like to, we're now at the end of our session. I'd like to ask our guest to give a 3-minute closing message. Maybe what you want to tell your constituents in your respective LGUs as well as the entire province of Cebu and whoever Filipino will see this session online. Ma'am Abby?
Okay. First, thank you for the invitation. And to all the viewers, considering the time we have spent saying to you our platform, addressing those theme of Mega Cebu, I do hope and pray that you will be guided and you can have you can decide wisely on the May 13th election. You have to consider that whatever would be your decision lies the future of your municipality, the province, and the Philippines as well. Thank you and God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Abby. Sir Froilan.
First, organizer aning a event. Thank you so much for the chance of being here and being heard by our constituents. So, sa tanang taga Compostela, ang ako lang ikasulti sa inyo, karong umabot election, this is a chance for us to improve our town. So, your one vote counts, and I hope you will be responsible for that vote because this would greatly affect our town. I'm not saying I'm the best guy in the town. Dili ako ang pinakamayang laki sa atong lungsod. Ang ako lang is magtinabangay ta, atong ipaasinso ang atong lungsod, atong panindutun ang atong lungsod. Kay kani, para lang ni kanato o para usab sa silinganan natong lungsod nga makasuroy nga safe, mahimo sang proud og masuroy sa atong lugar. And also, dili nato kalimtan ang atong tagline nga our home Compostela. Since we considered Compostela as our home, ato unta kining panggaon sama sa atong pagpangga sa tagsa-tagsa nato kabalay. In general, ako o ang akong kauban mga partidong bakod, ang among tuyog tumong lang mao ang pag-alagad kaninyo, ang paghatag ninyo og maayong pagpuyo, ang paghatag ninyo og mga nindot nga programa nga makatabang sa tagsa-tagsa nato ka pamilya. Daghang salamat ug maayong hapon kanatong tanan.
Daghang salamat, Sir Jimmy.
Akong kasing pasalamat no sa Mega Cebu o sa organizers nga paghatag o kahigayunan namo sa pagpadayag sa mga issues o ang among mga plataforma. Sa lungsod sa Liloan, nasayod mantang dunay mga issues nga dili maayo nga magapagka-implementar sumo na nga ato ng tarungon o kunya unsay ko ang atong punan. Now, in relation to sa mga development atong paningwaon o paningkamutan no nga ato yung ma-implementar para sa tinuod nga kalambuan no sa atong pinalanggang lugsod sa Liloan, ang pagbutar sa grado. So mo nang importante kaayo nga mopili ta sa tinuod ligdong o lumad nga Liloanon para sa tinuod nga kausaban, maggikan ka na sa tinuod nga kasing-kasing o nahona sa pagbutar sa maong kandidato. Daghang salamat o maing hapon.
Daghang salamat. Congressman Red.
Yes, first of all, I would like to thank Mega Cebu for inviting us this afternoon. O gusto na kong ipaabot akong kinasingkasing nga pagpasalamat ngadto sa mga kaigsuunan namo sa Quinto Distrito sa ilang suporta nga gihatag kanako sa upat ka termino isip kongresista sa Quinto Distrito. Sa tibuok panahon sa akong pagpanerbisyo, nakatunan yun nako og unsay pasabot niining politika. Ako sab nakatunan og unsag yoy buot tumong niining politika. Para kanako kining politika mo ang pagkabot ug pagpaabot sa mga kaayuhan ngadto sa katawhan pinaagi sa takos nga pagpanerbisyo. Ikaduha, kining politika para kanako mao ang pagpatigbabaw sa interes sa katawhan kaysa kaugalingon. Ang paghatag sa tinud-anay, kinasingkasing ug kanunayon nga pagpanerbisyo. Munang mauni ang akong panlantaw para sa atong Quinto Distrito nga adunay panaghiusa sa atong mga lideres para mapasigurado natong pagpaabot ang makalambuan ngadto sa komunidad kanato. So with that, I would like to remind the constituency of the 5th District nga sakto to ang gisulti ni Kapitan Jimmy nga the right to vote is sacred and let's not waste it by electing the wrong people and putting them in power. So maayong hapon ug daghang salamat.
Thank you very much. Can we give our candidates a round of applause? We will be showing to you the commitments that the candidates have made during the entire session. Are we ready to show? We have our one-man team at the back. All right, so we'll start with Congressman Red Durano. So, mauni ang mga punto, and then you can correct the item so that we can put that on record. We'll address unique problems of each locality. Why run to continue legacy of service of Grandpa Ramon Durano? Modern kasi Grandpa. Nagdali na gina itong documenter. Put people's interests first. Be sensitive to their needs. In the area or issue of traffic, 2 hours to reach Danao as per today. Ongoing road widening to 4 lanes. Developing alternate routes, Compostela to Talamban. Also sponsored House Bill for a land-based traffic management policy and LRT operation in Metro Cebu. For waste management, looking for funds for town solutions. And for water, Danao's bulk water system provides water at minimal cost. Water is protected, watershed is protected by law and dam under construction. In the issue of drugs, support the police and sports basketball tournament on its 9th year. Favor status quo and term limits. Honesty is a requirement for candidates and should be demanded by voters. For political dynasty, it's not an issue. At the end of the day, it's the people who decide who will govern. The key is whether you have the trust of the people. We are offering a brand of service that is tried, tested, and trusted. Okay. For a conversation with President Duterte, no instance yet, and we'll ask him about his political success. How did he actually do it? Okay. So with that, wala na kay add, sir?
Wala.
We hope it's okay if you can sign our buksay. Then, while Congressman Red is doing that, I'll read the... Yes, po. For Sir Jimmy Maglasam, why run? My strong desire to serve. Use my experience of 3 terms as barangay captain. For the issue of traffic, propose a diversion road to bypass town proper and a reclamation project to improve mobility. Waste management, favor purchasing a lot for a sanitary landfill in Liloan. Continue strong Puruk system. For water supply, push for alternative water system, artesian wells for communities, not just rely on MCWD connections. For drugs, support programs for surrenderers, conduct regular testing. Yes to extended term to 5 years, but only 2 terms in succession. Honesty is part of good governance. Dynasty is not an issue in 5th District. People freely choose leaders. And if given the chance to converse with President Duterte, review the impact of inflation on the poor. Anything else, sir? Sakto na? Okay. Thank you very much. Can we now have the next So Sir Jimmy will be signing Sir Froilan Quino. Why run? Community needs livelihood, jobs. In quotation, I will continue the good programs of present administration. For traffic, will propose master plan for road widening, propose to revive a railway system. Waste management, continue no plastic ordinance. Water supply, support ongoing water distribution system. Drugs problem is controlled through active youth programs and anti-drug councils. Term limit extension is not an issue for performers. Honesty should be part of criteria for public officials. Political dynasty not an issue in 5th District. And if given the chance to talk to President Duterte, thank you for changing peace and order situation in the country. And we'll ask, natabunan ni Sir Jimmy, how to find a partner in life. Okay, naapigin na siya on record. Paninglan, yun na to after this, after the election. Anything else, Sir Froilan? Only the spelling, kaya hindi siya mabutaran, basta wrong, na-misplace si I. Okay. Finally, for Ma'am Josephine Abing. Okay. Main challenge, tourism development of a pilgrimage route of Camino Santiago, which started in July 2016, a center of religious tourism. Meaning, say, Compostela becomes a religious center of religious tourism in Asia. Okay. Traffic, 2-hectare reclamation area could be an alternate route, exploring ferry service to Mactan, ongoing widening of diversion road with Cebu Province. Need to prepare for influx of people, vehicles with Consolacion's new container port. Waste management, a 10-year plan is already approved and you're buying a lot for sanitary landfill. Closed dam site now is converted into an eco park and an urban gardening showcase. Put up a center for VocTech training. For water supply, improve water quality, addressing hog raisers' waste, and more rainwater harvesting facility for businesses. Pay for drugs. Ongoing aftercare program. Yes to extended term limit beyond 3 successive terms. Honesty, be honest even if others are not. Strong yung si Ma'am Ato, no? For political dynasty, it exists in the now, but it's not a question if this is chosen by, or they are chosen by the people. Duranos are servant leaders. And if given a chance to talk to President Duterte, choose your words carefully. So, nani pangasaba gamay, Ma'am? Choose your words carefully and act appropriately in the right time. Do you have anything else to add? Okay, so I think our candidates here deserve a well round of applause from everybody.